Alright there, Fright Fiends, here's yet another Halloween special. And what am I looking at? I'm looking at Splatterhouse. And it's going to be a squishy good time, so get ready.
You ready, Vanessa?
Yeah, Vanessa's ready. Let's start saving some Jennifer.
Splatterhouse is the bloody gore fest that came out long before Mortal Kombat. And like Zombies Ate My Neighbors, this game is a game made by horror lovers. And it has such a unique style to it. And to say the least, it certainly is a style over substance type of game. Most of the gameplay is a matter of memorizing enemy actions, as enemies do the same thing every single playthrough. There's no deviation from action at all. If an enemy attacks in a certain way in the first level, he will always attack that way every single playthrough ever at all. That will ever come down the pike. Ever. It's just trial and error to get through until you know how to win. You got a punch, a jump, and a low kick to aid you through. You also get 2x4s, a meat cleaver, and a shotgun. The gameplay is simple, but I wouldn't say shallow. Like all good games, the story involves a stolen girl and her man coming to rescue her. In this case, protagonist Rick has his girlfriend Jennifer kidnapped by the evil Dr. Henry West, a clear reference to the H.P. Lovecraft story Reanimator. Rick, with the help of the evil Terror Mask, sets out to rescue Jennifer. With the terror mask on, which looks like a hockey mask, Rick very much resembles Jason Voorhees. He traverses Dr. West's mansion, fighting all kinds of sick monsters and ghouls. This is where Splatterhouse gets its name, and what it's most well known for, its gory aesthetic. Every level just drips with delightful gore and a love for 80s horror movies. Levels are just brimming over with gore. There's dead bodies laying all over the floor, corpses that hang from the ceiling, and splatter open when you hit them. Sometimes levels just have piles of fleshy mounds leaning up against the walls. The enemies themselves each resemble twisted human parodies. Sometimes you fight zombie dogs or flying furniture or even severed hands, which I imagine are references to Evil Dead. They even flip you off. Look at that. They're giving you the bird right there. This game has no respect. No respect at all. The game just taunts you the whole way through. At one point in the game, you pass a bunch of mirrors and have to fight mirror versions of Rick. Bosses run the gambit from floating furniture you have to fight, which I believe is a reference to Poltergeist, but I could be wrong. Other bosses include a man with two chainsaws for hands and a sack over his head. I think the developers meant this to be a reference to both Friday the 13th Part 2 and Evil Dead. And if they didn't mean for it to be that, well, fudge. It's what it reminds me of. Other bosses include severed heads surrounding an inverted cross, a bunch of whatever these worms are, and Rick's girlfriend Jennifer. She's the boss right before the final boss. Unfortunately, I can't beat her, so I haven't actually completed the game. I know you fight a head that comes out of the ground in a forest that's on fire. Jennifer is a hard boss, and the level leading up to her is just as hard. Several levels have splitting paths, and this level is one of them. If you fall through a hole in the floor, you end up in this level, and it's here that I get my ass kicked. There's this flying guy and these zombies, and the flying guy keeps resurrecting the zombies. You have to kill the flying guy to continue while fending off the zombies. And should I actually defeat the flying guy and get to Jennifer, I only usually have a hit or two left, and she takes me out every time. It's hard, just painfully hard. I'll beat it one day though, you watch, I'll beat it. In total, Splatterhouse is a unique game for its time. It provides a unique love experience for horror fans, and I wish that there were more games like it, both then and now. It's gory and moody and creepy, taking you through a haunted mansion and forests. It's good stuff. It's darn good stuff.
And that's Splatterhouse, the arcade game. It's a gosh darn good game. I really enjoy it. Its horror theme's amazing. It's awesome. So if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. Or check out this video, which is my review of Contra on the PS2. Or check out this video right here, which is my review of Rare Game Boy games on the Game Boy Color by Capcom. It's got Resident Evil Gaiden in it. You might like it. Check it out.